So my name is Victor Tino Amisi. I'm born again, and welcome to my YouTube page of Check on a Man. It's a page whereby we share, we do men, and we help men heal from depression. So please remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel page and like.
And today I want us to talk about one topic, the reason to why most men can't open up and share what they are going through. So subscribe and let's listen. So what's your name, please?
My name is Musule Moses from Bungoma, but Komalapa represented the what men goes through about.
What's your name, bro?
My name is Agre Ambuche, and I'm from Mombasa, and I'm here to present what men go through.
So friends, let's talk about this topic. Unadhani ni nini kinafanya wanaume wasifungwe mioyo zao na kusema zile vitu wanapitia? What is that thing that makes you as a man inafanya? Maybe you go through something and kabla ufike kwa suicide, unasema siezi ambia mtu kitu yenye napitia saa hizi. What is that one thing that you think you need as a man to open up?
Okay, mi kulingana na mimi, unajua mwanaume ni mtu mwenye aliumbwa tofauti sana. Na mara mingi, yani mwanaume akipata kitu kama okay, akikuwa na stress, mambo mengi akiyapitia, anaonanga yeye anaweza ku handle personally. So anakaa CV, yani akiambia mzee atakuwa desperate, ama huyo mzee atamjaji ni kana kwamba huyo mzee yani ajui kitu chenye anafanya. So inabidi ajikaushe tu nayo, anaweza decide atakwenda kwa club akunywe, ama atafute demo aenda shughulike na yeye, na yani ni kana kwamba ame release ile stress, but still bado anabaki tu, yani anataka kujiaccommodate mwenyewe.
What about you, mzee? What is that one thing unafikiria
Me, what I think what make men not open up is ignorance. Sometimes inaweza kuwa watu unaweza kuwa una ignore. Unaweza kuwa kuna depression, lakini sometimes unaona kama mwanamume kuna vitu zingine inaitwanga proud, as in pride, kuna kuangalia ego. Unaona? Kuna vile uwezi confront mwanamume mwenzako. Kuna mwanamume mwingine ukikonfront unaogopa kwamba ukimconfront ataweza kutoa siri yako.
Unaona? Wewe mwenyewe wewe umeoa?
Mimi nimeoa tayari.
Then tuambie nini kinaweza fanya usiambie mke wako ya kwamba una battle is e depression ama hii shida?
Fear. Mimi nikiogopa kumwambia. Unaona? Kama mimi naogopa tayari, nimeenda nyumbani niko na shida, niko na stress. Unaona? Na hii stress zangu sitaki nimwambie. Kwa sababu gani? Nikimwambia kwake pia itakuwa shida. Kwake nikimwambia, sasa mimi sitaki kumfanya nini? Kumuingiza depression zingine. Afadhali mimi ni nyamazie na hizo shida za na shida zangu mwenyewe. What I think pia sangine pia ni lack of money. Usipokuwa na pesa pia.
Ngoja kidogo. Umesema kwamba uko na mke na fear inafanya usi open up kwa mke wako. But most women are the best. Women are the best who can control emotions. They know how to deal with emotion. Because the Bible says, he who finds a wife finds a good thing and gaineth favor from the Lord. So women are emotional beings. That's why mwanamke atakupenda kwa sababu kwa zile maneno umemwambia. Mwanaume wewe wapenda kwa macho, eh? Kwa macho kabla umpende kwa emotions. Women know how to deal with emotions. And when you married a helper, sindio? So why can't you trust your helper?
Though kuna wanasemaga you can trust somebody, but you can't trust that totally 100%. Unaona? So
why?
Because there are some things I don't need to tell my wife. Unaona? Kwa mke wangu kuna vitu zingine, kwa account kama pesa kwa account, sio lazima nikuwe namwambia. Afaya ajue kwamba niko na biashara fulani kando yake. Unaona? Kuna vitu zingine naweza mwambia, lakini kuna vingine siwezi mfungulia. Unaona?
Kwa nini?
Kwa sababu haifai.
Kwa nini haifai?
Afadhali nimfungulie mwanamume mwenzangu. Unaona? Shida zangu,
bro. Huyu ni mkeo ambayo mimi na wewe kama rafiki yangu tutaachana jioni saa hizi uende kwa nyumba. Huu ni mtu utalala naye. Huu ni mtu atakusaidia ukue. Huu ni mtu ambaye ako na wewe kwa dhiki na faraja. Kwa nini usimwambie siri zako na kusaidie, na yeye ndio msaidizi, anaitwa msaidizi.
Unajua ukitoboa kwa siri zako zote kwa mwanamke, wewe utakuwa kama weak. Unaona? Usikue yani wiki tunasemaje kwa Kiswahili? Mnyonge. Ukisopolea bibi yako siri zote utakuwa mnyonge kwake. Atakuwa na wewe ni mnyonge. Kwa sababu gani? Wewe uwezi fanya chochote. Kile kitu utakufanya wewe utabidi uko namwambie. Unamwambia. Hiyo ni unyonge. Mimi kwangu mimi sinaona kama unyonge. Sasa mwambia. Asante.
So most of the men say that if you open up to a man, your fellow man, it will show that you're weak. And friends, I don't think that opening up as a man to your wife will make you a weak man. So I want us to have this conversation with an intelligent young pastor coming. He's a very good friend of mine. And let's hear what he'll have to say about this. So let me welcome a friend of mine, Pastor. Pastor, please, if you can join us.
My name is TK Daniels, Tony Kamau. Daniels, my father. And I think the first question is, why did God create a woman? If you want to know, or if you want to get an answer of what you're asking, the first question is, why did God create a woman? Number one reason. A woman was created for the purposes of making a man happy. And so the question is, if you say that you won't share with your wife, if you say that you won't talk to your wife, it means that she's not a person that you can trust. And every person, and I think what men should understand, a woman should be a companion. A woman should be a friend. A woman should be that person. I mean, I'm talking about a wife now. When you're married as a man, you're always supposed to be taking that woman as a friend. A person you're supposed to be opening up every now and then. And that's why you're hearing today, we're having cases of even infidelity, of deaths, people killing each other. Why? We have not yet accepted our wives as our best friends. Meaning, whatever I'm doing outside there, I cannot share with my wife. Why? She's not my friend. If you're my friend, I will share with you. We have shared with you a lot of, we keep on sharing every now and then with you or so many things. Why? Because you're my friend. And so the question is, if you have a woman as a wife whom you're not sharing with, is she a friend? Do you share almost everything with your best friend?
Yeah, I do. Like many times I come to you and I keep on, when I walk out of your place, I feel relieved. And even sometimes when you come at, you come and meet me, you share what you're going through and you feel relieved. So the a friend is someone you trust fully. A friend is not like God. To me, it's a small G God. It's a small G God. And a woman is a representation of God, because God said, "Let make a companion for a woman." And she's from my rib, so meaning she's me, she's me. So if I can't trust myself, meaning I can't trust any woman. So what is it, that one thing that makes men run to drugs, run to committing suicide, and cannot trust women?
Wow. First of all, drugs and so many other things that you're talking about, they comes in because there's a gap. There's a gap that men have not filled. And if you inquire much about drug cases, infidelity, sexuality, immorality, it starts because this person is suffering from something. And if only we can learn, and I've been telling this, in fact, I've been saying, I have a book about men, and I've been telling our women, and almost every other place I go, I keep on talking about this. If we focus too much about empowering the men generation.
Repeat that again.
If we talk much about, and we focus much about empowering the men generation, this means that we don't even need to empower these women. If you're well taken care of as a man, if you're very much well empowered as a man, you take good care of your sister, should not be in any danger, your wife will not be under any kind of risk, your friend who is a woman, a lady friend, should not be under any risk, she can trust you. It's not about sex, it's not about all this. You know, we have men who normally view women as an object of sex. There is nothing else you see in a woman. And that's why we don't trust women nowadays. We think they're just but sex object. We don't trust them as human beings. And if only we men now, we can rise up to a level of trying to empower ourselves. But the problem is, and that's why you see so many men are running into drugs. Do you know why? I cannot help you as a friend. as men we hate each other. No man will ever help a fellow man. If I'm falling today and I call you as a friend and tell you, my friend, Mazi, naumia mahali, I need 100 shillings, I need food, you not give me, you talk about me. But if a lady friend calls you today and she tells you, bro, Mazi ni aje, sina credo, and she's talking about credit, mini kuna kuitisha unga, that girl is talking about credit, you'd rather send to her, but you fail me.
By the way, pastor, it is easy for a man to give a woman 1,000, but it is hard for him to give his fellow man that 100 shillings. And let's talk about the issue of, because we are talking about the topic of depression in men, and I want us to candidly focus on much into depression and avoid these other topics. So what is this that you say that there's something called gap, there's a gap. And there's trust issues. What is it, that one thing that we can do to fill in that gap and to bring it trust issue? Because at the end of the day, I'm trusting for one thing, yeah? Men, for marriage to work, there's a very big gap of marriage, of people not trusting that marriage can work these days. Yeah? And I think it's one topic that is very deep that you can discuss next time.
Yeah.
So let's talk about this gap and this drug abuse and these trust issues.
Wow, about now men and women.
Yeah.
First and foremost, the way we are choosing our women before we get married.
Let's talk about the man first.
The man first.
Yes.
As a man, the man factor, I won't talk about the man factor. And the reason as to why we are having a gap in all these many things is because a man has forgotten something. And the thing is, God being the center of this whole issue. Who is a man? A man was created in God's image. Clear? And that means God was creating another man. And therefore, every time you as a man, you alienate yourself from the creator and from the purpose of creation, of which the purpose of creation was man to be like a God, a man to be living like a God. Every man should understand very clearly that he is operating as another God. And who is God? God is the creator. And that means if you are a man, you're supposed to be a creator, innovator. But the question is, are we being trained to be innovators? Are we being trained to be creators? It started when we started empowering women and forget about men. 20 years ago, 30 years ago, women were being told, if for you to succeed in life, you need to look for a man who is working and get married over there. Today, our women are being told, you don't need a man for you to succeed. But what are we telling our men? You know, I talk to students, high schools, everywhere. I see myself being challenged by the fact of nenda kongelesha my boys. Nambiwa, tell these boys that they don't need to marry. They don't have to need to marry a woman who is not working.